RC, when I talk about getting it together,
yeah,
a godsend for Sean Strickland, right?
Absolutely.
Change the conversation. We both know that when you're dealing in a bad media cycle, all you want is for the page to turn.
Absolutely.
What a page turn for Sean Strickland. He got a fight announced. He's going to Madison Square Garden, and now what is going to be the biggest spot of his career as he takes on the former champion, my buddy Luke Rockhold.
Yep.
This was a godsend for Sean Strickland, right? To get this fight announced now.
This is perfect for him. And this is what happens, though. You know, they say, DC, they say winning cures all. Right, and him winning this fight got him a fight, a step up in competition, a step up in name, a step up in venue, a step up in opportunity. Because that's what winning UFC fights in the fashion that he did against the person he wanted against gets you. And listen, man, and this is, I'm about to fanboy a little bit, right? And I'm sorry, DC, but when you know a dude has names like Machida, right, Vitor Belfort, right? Michael Bisping, Chris Weidman. When those guys are on your record, when you have fought against that level of competition, that level of greatness in name, that's a big deal. And now if you're Sean Strickland, you're another dude that's going to be on that resume. Now, this can be a win against a Luke Rockhold, a guy now you get to have an opportunity to have another presser and say, you know what? What I said last time, I get it, but I've moved on from that. And look at the way I fought tonight against who is truly, to at least a fan like me, a legend of this game.
You know what's crazy about it also is that for Sean Strickland, he gets a chance to go and make it right. But he gets a chance to go and make it right on a bigger stage.
Right.
This fight card is turning out to be one of the biggest ones of the entire year in Madison Square Garden with the fights that are already announced. Sean Strickland can get past Luke Rockhold. He truly has an opportunity to do a lot of things and correct a lot of things that he may have dealt with in the past. But the reality is this. Luke Rockhold is still as difficult for anyone in the world. I know everybody talks about he doesn't have a chin. If you can hit him, you're going to knock him out.
You got to hit him.
He's not as good. You got to hit him.
You got to hit him.
Right? And he's been away for a while. He hasn't fought since he fought against Jan Błachowicz. But when you look back on the Błachowicz fight, Luke's first time up at 205, right? Gets knocked out bad. Błachowicz looks like, wow, how do you lose to a guy that's not that good? Well, time.
Look where it is now. Time reveals all.
Time reveals all, and time has allowed for that loss to age beautifully.
Absolutely.
Because Jan went on to knock out Corey Anderson, who's doing his thing in Bellator. Jan went out to knock out Dominic Reyes,
fresh
who had fought
John Jones
so close. Jan then beats Israel Adesanya to show how valuable he is. So that loss has aged really well for Luke Rockhold.
Absolutely, and those are the things that you want to see happen after you lose to a guy like Jan Błachowicz, because that's a situation where it's like, oh, maybe your career is over. But you think about the knockout power, being able to knock out a Dominic Reyes, you say, oh, this dude is different, right? Dominic Reyes goes five rounds with John Jones.
And many people thought he won the fight.
Absolutely. And now you're knocked out, what was it, the second round?
Yeah,
and so you're showing.
Bad too.
So now, but if you're Luke Rockhold and you know this better than me, DC, you understand your back is against the wall. You understand how people are looking at you. You've been away from the sport, as you said, and you hear the question marks. Question marks is, can my chin hold up? Where you're fighting a guy in Sean Strickland who's a volume guy.
Yeah, he's not a guy that just puts you to sleep.
Exactly. He's a volume guy. So you feel you can devise a plan where you can use your skill, use your experience to get this win. And so he has to be excited about this matchup, too, against a dude whose name is now ringing. Like, I'm going to be honest with you. When I saw the Uriah Hall, Sean Strickland trailer, I got excited. My son, who's into mixed martial arts as much as me, he was so excited about the ESPN Plus. He said, you know what? I like this Strickland guy. He's talking about violence. Now he gets another chance to show us that.
You know, the thing about Rockhold and the Strickland fight, it got offered to him earlier. He told me about it. He goes, it doesn't get me excited. I want something that's going to get the juices flowing for a former champion. But then now, a week after he beats a Uriah Hall, that fight gets announced because now Sean Strickland becomes more viable. Sean Strickland's name has a little bit more momentum, And now Luke Rockhold can see himself standing across the octagon from.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.